Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. In today's video, I'll show you how to transform a shot done on a cell phone, iPhone, or Android device, and taking it from looking just like this into looking like that. And it's going to be a little easy process, a little bit of color grading, some object removal, and stuff like that. So without further ado, let's jump into DaVinci Resolve and start to transform the iPhone shot. Okay, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve, and we are going to have a look at how to improve this shot here done on an iPhone and how we can improve that inside of DaVinci Resolve. So first off, we're just going to jump into the color page, and in the color page, we are just going to zoom in just a little bit on this clip here, and obviously there are some problems. Actually, I'm a little bit out of focus and the background is more in focus than me, but we can fix that. Also, we have this light switch here, which doesn't look very good. However, sometimes you can't move light switches for real, and you couldn't for this shot move the camera anymore to make this shot. There is simply not enough room in this tiny space I was shooting this thing in. But anyways, let's fix this shot. So first off, let's just go and have a look at our scopes here, and we're going to go into the gain, and I'm going to drag that down so we're not clipping the highlights, and then I'll go into the lift and I'm going to raise that so we're not going to cross the blacks, and we're just doing something super basic for this. So I'm going to put in a little saturation. I'll go up here to the contrast. I'm going to put in a little contrast here, and in the temperature, I might make this a little bit warmer, something like that. And then in the color boost, I could boost in the colors, but I'm not going to do that. I'm going to drag out a little bit of the colors, something like that. I think for this little shot here, I think that is okay. This is a very small correction. So what I want to do now, I'll go into the edit page. I'm going to highlight my clip. I'm going to push Alt, and then I'm just going to drag and do a copy. And again, for tutorial purposes and easy to figure out what is what, I'm going to right click, and I'm just going to change the clip color to orange. And then I'm just going to go back to the color page. So with the second clip here selected, or the orange one, I'm going to use one of the studio features, and this should be enough just to get the studio version. I'm going to use the magic mask. However, you could do this without the magic mask. You just have to mask me out, and that could be something that takes a long time. So I'm just going to go into the option here of better. I'm going to click right here to have my overlay so I can see myself here, and I'm just going to draw on me, something like that. And we can see it has done a pretty good job. And then I'll just click right here to track forward and backward, and it shouldn't take too long. Again, it's super fast at tracking stuff, and it is doing a very good job, I think. So there we are, almost at the end here. I really think that the tracking is really, really good in DaVinci when you're talking about the magic mask. Amazing. It's doing a phenomenal job, I think. And it's only going to be better in the future, I think. So with that done, I'm going to right click out here in empty space, and I'm going to add an alpha out. And I'm just going to connect that right here. So what I'm going to do for this clip here, I'm going to go into this here, and then I'm just going to zoom in a bit, and I'm going to sharpen that. And you'll do that by dragging just here. And I'm going to, let's sharpen it to 41 or something. So we can take off the, and we can see we are sharpening it just a tad. To make the other clip a little nicer, I'm going to make that out of focus. But before I'm going to make that out of focus, I'm going to jump on the clip here. And then I'll just go up here to my effects here, and I'm just going to search for patch. And here we have the patch replacer, and I'm going to drag that onto my clip. And now we have these two ellipses here. I'm going to change that into a rectangle. And the idea here is to move this up here, and then I'm going to take the other one and put that on top of my switch. And that's just done like that. And as long as I'm not covering anything here, we should be good to go like that. What I then want to do with that selected, I'll go into the same one here, into the blur, in the radius, and I'm just going to drag that upwards. And then you can take it all the way up, and that's going to look too crazy. So you will find a middle ground where you think it's okay. Maybe something like that. Not too crazy, just like a little out of focus does a lot. So if we go into the clip now, we can have a look at how that actually looked. So I think this is a super easy way of creating this effect, that we were shooting this on a camera where we actually have a little bit of shallow depth of field. And of course we could do a little more than this, but for this clip, I think this worked pretty well. And then of course we did remove this switch here, which are making this shot look a lot better. Anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.